My name is Vin Pilleri. I am a professor of head and neck surgery here at the Royal Marsden Hospital.
My name is Asif Chowdhury. I'm an esophageal and gastric cancer surgeon.
My name is Miles Smith, and I'm a consultant general surgeon and surgical oncologist.
The future of cancer care is bright. We are constantly pushing boundaries. We're doing things we never thought we could do even a decade ago. So I think, give it another 10 years, we'll be doing things that will be truly the future.
So one of the recent innovations in imaging technology is the development of holographic imaging and the ability to segment cross-sectional imaging. So what that means is we're able to generate models that we can look at and take apart. We can use that potentially to plan surgery. We can use that in the future to potentially guide surgery. So we commonly see this in games like Pokemon Go, when sometimes you're planning where to put furniture in the rooms. But what we will use it for is to help plan complex sarcoma operations and potentially guide some melanoma surgery. It'll be helpful for trainees. It'll be very helpful for patients to be able to show them holographic images to show them what we'll do.
So I think we're going to see a significant change. For example, some of the work we're doing, we have within the animal model defined a small robot, a micro robot, that can see, that can smell tumor and can cut tumor. So translating that, I kid you not, translating that to the human, it's just a matter of time.
I think in the future, more patients will become operable because of an improvement in the other treatments that they receive. More patients will receive keyhole treatments because robotic surgery, for instance, is going to get better and better. And it's going to get better and better through a convergence of different technological improvements. So improvements in optics, improvements in mechatronics or the actual sort of mechanics of robotics, improvements in artificial intelligence being integrated with things like machine vision, for instance. You know, a lot is changing. At the moment, when we carry out robotic surgery, we're often using machines such as the machine behind me, which is the Da Vinci Xi, which is large. There is a big move to develop what we call soft robotics, or newer types of robots that actually mimic animals and their limbs and in the biological world, which can change their structure and shapes, often in a much more sort of miniaturized form, in the nooks and crannies of the internal structures and organs and against the contours of the body. So I think all of this is just going to get better and better.
Fluorescence guided surgery is a hot topic at the moment. It's a new tool whereby we can use specific and non-specific probes that essentially will light up and be able to demonstrate anatomy or particular targets. And what that means is you can use, for example, a compound called ICG, indocyanine green. We use it routinely for melanoma surgery, and we use that to help identify the sentinel lymph nodes. What we do is we have a camera, it shines a light, and then we can project an image up onto the screen, and we can identify on the screen where the lymph node is, and then we can take that specific lymph node out, and in time, you could potentially use that or similar technologies to specifically light up melanoma and other cancers to guide surgery.
For us as a team of experts at the Royal Marsden to be able to innovate and to be able to deliver really sort of cutting edge treatments, we need persistent, ongoing financial support, and much of that comes from our very generous donors who donate to the Royal Marsden Cancer Charity.